Today we are going to talk about random process.
No, satama, sir.
Random process. A random variable which maps together with the time. Together with the time is said to be random process. Random process. So take a random variable which assigns a time function. For instant time t, that is for each time we assign a time function for each random variable, then it is called random process. Random process. Okay, actually what is the meaning of for each output is which each outcome is recorded in a time domain. Time domain. Okay, that is called random process. So we should associate a time function for each random variable, assigns a time varying functions for instant time t. It's called random process. Okay, so we saw random process. We now see the classification of random process. So classification of random process. What are the classification we have? We have stationary random process, and then we have strict sense random. RP stands for random process. Strict sense random process. Third one is wide sense random process. So basically, the example we state for stationary is signal. Signal. So when you use, we state an example for the signal. Example for a stationary process, random process, signal. Okay, when you use signal receiving through noise and voice. These are an example for stationary process. And we can say that for strictly stationary, but wide sense is nothing but weak performance. Weak performance of the stationary. Weak performance of the stationary is stationary. Wide sense, stationary random process. After that we have Markov process. And then Poisson process. Poisson process. Finally, we have one more process. Ergodic. So we now state each random process with their conditions. So let us take x of t be a random process. So let us take first x of t a random process. Then x of t is said to be stationary of first order. Stationary of first order. If E of x of t, that is mean, must be constant. This is a condition for stationary of first order. So an x of t is said to be stationary of first order. if E of x of t is, that is mean to be constant. If you take f triple s, I hope you all know that triple s. So triple s means strict sense stationary, means the stationary of second order. Stationary of second order, okay. For stationary of second order, we state the condition as if mean is constant and variance also constant. So constant means it does not depends upon time function. So does not depends upon, not depends on time, not depends on time, both should be constant, both should be constant. These are the condition for strict sense stationary. Strict sense, okay, strict sense stationary condition is mean to be constant and variance to be constant. Okay, let us go to the next. Now we state the condition for WSS. WSS means wide sense stationary or weak sense. So we say weak sense stationary. For this, what is the condition we have is if mean of, that is E of x of t, must be constant, and then Rxx of tau, that is auto correlation, that is auto correlation, auto correlation is a function of tau. What is tau? Tau is nothing but t1 minus t2, the difference between t1 minus t2. That is, we say that t1 as t and t2 we can take as t plus tau. Their difference is said to be tau. Tau is nothing but t1 minus t2. So when you evaluate autocorrelation for a given random process, it must be a function of tau. That is, tau is function of t1. Okay, let us move on to the
in the video pichinda like pannunga, share pannunga, subscribe pannunga.